A very good morning to you all children. Welcome to today's class. Our last lesson was structure and function of living organisms, plants. So today we are going to learn about structure and function of living organisms, that is animals. Our body. So what are the main organs which are present in our body? So coming to the organs and organ systems, first we should know what is a cell. So cell is the smallest unit of a living organism, or you can say that cell is the structural and functional unit of living organisms, or the basic unit of life. So group of cells form a tissue, and tissues collectively form organs, and the different organs working together for a certain major activity form an organ system. So we have so many organ systems in our body, children, which are performing major activity, some functions in our body. So there are many systems in our body. In that system, today we are going to discuss about the digestive system. You have already learned about the process of digestion in your lower classes. So now let us have a quick recap of what is digestion and about the parts of digestive system. The process of breaking down of food into very fine and soluble particles is called digestion, or breaking down of the complex materials into simpler and soluble form is called as digestion. The parts of digestive system are already you have learned in your lower classes, children. They are mouth, food pipe, stomach, liver and pancreas, which are the glands, associated glands, small intestine, large intestine, rectum and anus. So these are all the parts of digestive. The picture of digestive system, children, where you can see the first part in the digestive system is nothing but the mouth, which consists of three main parts, that is the tongue, the salivary glands. These are the salivary glands which you can see here, and you have the teeth. So the mouth consists of three main parts, that is teeth, tongue and salivary glands. And then from the mouth, the food enters through the food pipe. The food pipe is also called as esophagus, and then it reaches to the stomach, liver, and this is pancreas, which helps in digestion. And then it goes into the small intestine, and then to the large intestine, and comes out, the undigested food comes out through the anus. So this is about the parts. So let us go to the first part of the digestive system, that is the mouth. The mouth is also called as oral cavity. So the process of digestion begins in the mouth. So in the mouth itself, the digestion starts. So this mouth consists of three parts, as we discussed. That is about the teeth. You can see the teeth in this picture, children. Then the tongue. This is the tongue which is helping us to taste the different types of food items. And then we have the salivary glands. So salivary glands, you know that it secretes saliva, which is helpful for the digestion of the food. So coming to the teeth. There are two sets of teeth which is formed during one's lifetime, and that is temporary teeth and permanent teeth. The temporary teeth is also called as the milk teeth, which are 20 in number, and permanent teeth, which are 32 in number. Teeth are the hard structures that have two parts, the crown and the root. This part is called as a crown. And the down part, what you have, that is called as a root. The crown is a visible part. The upper part which you can see, that is nothing but the crown. And the root is inside the gums which are present. And it is attached to the socket or the jawbone. So these bones, these are called as jawbones. The upper jaw and the lower jaw. So in this jawbones, we can see the teeth. The outer white part of the teeth is made of enamel, and the hardest substance which is known present in our body is nothing but the enamel. And what is the use of teeth, children? The teeth is used for the crushing or grinding or chewing the food. Yes, so there are four types of teeth. Sets are two, types are four. Four types of teeth, that is incisors, canines, premolars and molars, right? So incisors are used for cutting the food, canines are used for tearing the food, premolars and molars are used for crushing and grinding the food. Okay, and the last pair of the molar teeth is called as wisdom teeth, and this will be formed when the person is of 20 years old. So this is about the teeth. So coming to the tongue, children, we know that tongue is a muscular organ and it helps to taste the food. So it not only helps to taste the food, it also helps in speech, and it mixes the food with the saliva to make it soft, and also for identifying the different types of taste. So you can see some tiny bumps on the teeth, and that is nothing but called as taste buds. So this is about the tongue, children. Coming to the third part, that is salivary glands. So you can see clearly here, salivary glands. There are three pairs of salivary glands which are present in the mouth, and it secretes, the salivary glands secretes a watery fluid which is called as saliva, and this saliva helps in moistening the food. In the sense, it makes the food wet and soften. It helps to make the food wet and soften, and so that the food can be easily swallowed. An adult secretes about 1 liter of saliva. An adult secretes about 1 liter of saliva a day, and the salivary glands sometimes get stimulated. See, children, when you see any the sweet whichever you like, or an ice cream, or any other food which you like, immediately you can see that, you can find that your salivary glands will be secreting the saliva, and you feel it gets stimulated by seeing or by even smelling also sometimes. Okay, children. So when you see some delicious food, your mouth starts wetting. In the sense, it becomes moist because of the salivary glands which is secreting the saliva. So this is about the first part in the digestive system, that is about the mouth, or it is also called as oral